Searching for geometry node tutorials on how to make rope bridges or power lines gives many great results. However, they share one fatal flaw. They all use Bézier curves to model the shape of the suspended cables. I'm sorry to tell you, but the correct shape is not a parabola, but rather a catenary curve. The difference may seem subtle, but it becomes more obvious for lower hanging cables. Let's look at some examples of catenary curves in real life. A hanging chain, power lines, even spider webs. What about here? Well, let me just flip it 180 degrees. I think my case is clear. Catenary curves are everywhere. I therefore consider it my moral duty to teach you how to create these curves in Blender. What do we need? Well, we have three inputs. The two endpoints, which are just points in 3D space, and finally the amount of droop, or sag. Let us first consider a simpler case. Here we have two points at heights y1 and y2 with a horizontal distance of 1 between them. Given the parameter a, which controls the flatness of the curve, we need to find a catenary between the two points. We have 2 degrees of freedom, the catenary's x offset and the y offset. Luckily, we only have two constraints, the heights y1 and y2, so we can write this down as a system of two equations in two variables. As it turns out, with some work, one can find a unique solution given by the following equations. Although these equations look intimidating, once we have them as a node group, we never need to think of them again. To create the node group, I make use of my math formula add-on to speed up the process. Now, given the offsets, making the 2D catenary node group is easy. The input x gives how far we are along the curve, while the output y gives the height of the catenary at that point. To create the actual curve geometry, we start out with a curve line node, and then add two empties to control the endpoints. Remember that we assumed that the points were a distance of 1 apart? This works out nicely with the spline parameter node, which gives a factor that goes from 0 to 1 along the curve. The two heights are simply the z components of our two endpoints. We can now use the y output of our node group to set the height of the catenary. And with that, we're basically done. We just have one final input to deal with, the parameter a. The bigger a is, the stiffer the curve. Conversely, values of a close to 0 lead to a lot of droop. To make things easier to work with, we can invert the input. This way, the input parameter controls the amount of droop in the curve. I'll put a link to a blend file with this node group in the description. That way, you can start using it immediately. Well, that was all. You can now start using mathematically correct hanging cables.